our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today we celebrate the votive mass of the mystery of the Holy Cross. And I offer this mass for Sister Pedraza. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the country of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who willed that your only begotten Son should undergo the cross to save the human race, grant, we pray, that we who have known his mystery on earth may merit the grace of his redemption in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second letter of St. Peter. Beloved, wait for and hasten the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be dissolved in flames and the elements melted by fire. But according to his promise, we await new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, since you await these things, be eager to be found without spot or blemish before him, at peace. And consider the patience of our Lord as salvation. Therefore, beloved, since you are forewarned, be on your guard not to be led into the error of the unprincipled and to fall from your own stability. But grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. To him be glory now and to the day of eternity. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Before the mountains were begotten, and the earth and the world were brought forth, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. You turn man back to dust, saying, return, O children of men. For 1,000 years in your sight are as yesterday, now that it is past, or as a watch of the night. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. 70 is the sum of our years, or 80 if we are strong. And and most of them are fruitless toil, for they pass quickly and you drift away. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Fill us at daybreak with your kindness, that we may shout for joy and gladness all our days, that your work be seen by your servants, and your glory by their children. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
In the Gospel, we heard Jesus Christ tell us that we must give the Caesar what is Caesar's and to God what is God's. And it is precisely the first commandment that forbids us to worship anyone other than the one God. St. Thomas Aquinas explained to us one of the reasons why we should worship only God. We must love Him for the dignity of God. To take away His dignity is an insult. This is something we see among us. Dignity is always due proper reverence. So he who denies reverence to the king is a traitor, and it belongs to the dignity of God to know everything. So the word God in Greek derives from the verb to see. Such is in fact one of the attributes of the divinity. That is why the letter to the Hebrews says that all things are naked and manifest in God's sight. Therefore, we must love God with all if we give to him and the any creature what is due to God, we must not complain that we are not happy. Let us ask our Heavenly Mother for the grace to give God what is God's, and to the creatures what is of the creatures. En el Evangelio hemos escuchado que Jesucristo nos dice que hay que dar a César lo que es de César y a Dios lo que es de Dios. Y justamente el primer mandamiento nos prohíbe adorar a otro que no sea el mismo Dios. Nos manda a darle a Dios lo que es de Dios. Santo Tomás de Aquino nos explica uno de los motivos de por qué debemos adorar solo a Dios. Debemos amarlo por la divinidad que tiene Dios. Quitarle la divinidad es una injuria. Esto es algo que lo vemos entre nosotros. Cada divinidad se le debe una adecuada reverencia. Por eso, el que le niega reverencia al rey es un traidor, por ejemplo. Y pertenece a la divinidad de Dios el saberlo todo. La palabra de Dios en griego deriva del verbo ver. Tal es en efecto uno de los atributos de la divinidad, el ver todo. Por eso dice en la carta a los Hebreos, todas las cosas están desnudas y manifiestas a los ojos de Dios. Por lo tanto, a Dios lo debemos amar con todo el corazón, y esto implica no ocultarle nada, ni negarle ningún acto de amor. Y si le damos a César o a alguna criatura lo que le corresponde a Dios, no debemos quejarnos de no ser felices. A nuestra Madre del Cielo pidámosle hoy entonces la gracia de darle a Dios lo que es de Dios, por lo tanto todo nuestro corazón, y al César lo que es del César. brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his holy church.
May this oblation, Lord, which on the altar of the cross concealed the offense of the whole world, cleanse us, we pray, of all our sins, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
El Señor esté con ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu.
Levantemos el corazón.
Lo tenemos levantado hacia el Señor.
Demos gracias al Señor nuestro Dios. En verdad es justo y necesario, en nuestro deber y salvación, darte gracias siempre y en todo lugar, Señor Padre Santo, Dios Todopoderoso y Eterno, porque has puesto la salvación del género humano en el árbol de la cruz, para que de donde tuvo origen la muerte, de allí resurgiera la vida, y el que en un árbol venció, fuera en un árbol vencido por Cristo, Señor nuestro. Por él celebran tu majestad los ángeles, te adoran las dominaciones, se estremecen las potestades, te celebran unidos en la alegría de los cielos, las virtudes celestiales y los bienaventurados serafines. Permítenos asociarnos a sus voces, cantando humildemente tu alabanza. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, the forgiveness of sins." Christ, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you through all the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him.
Fieles a la recomendación del Salvador y siguiendo su divina enseñanza, nos atrevemos a decir, Padre nuestro, que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre, venga a nosotros tu reino, hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día, perdona nuestras ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden, no nos dejes caer en la tentación y líbranos del mal. Líbranos de todos los males, Señor, y concédenos la paz en nuestros días, para que, ayudados por tu misericordia, vivamos siempre libres de pecado y protegidos de toda perturbación, mientras esperamos la gloriosa venida de nuestro Salvador Jesucristo. Señor Jesucristo, que dijiste a tus apóstoles, la paz les dejo, mi paz les doy. No tengas en cuenta nuestros pecados, sino la fe de tu iglesia. Y conforme a tu palabra, concede la paz y la unidad. Tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén.
La paz del Señor esté siempre con ustedes.
Thank you.
Dichosos los invitados a la cena del Señor. to the glory of the resurrection.